Welcome back to this edition of Sarasota Business Today. I'm your host, Jeff Maltzby. As promised, we're here at the beautiful Hyatt Regency in downtown Sarasota with our guest, Dr. Sean Snaith from the University of Central Florida, who's in town on his annual economic development outlook and forecast for the year 2012. Dr. Snaith, welcome.
Jeff, thanks for having me.
It's always a pleasure. We really look forward to you coming back every year. Tell us something good this year. Take out your crystal ball and let us know what you think.
All right. Well, it looks like a snow globe these past couple years, but peering into it now, the good news is I think 2012 will continue the recovery. The bad news is that recovery is going to continue to be somewhat tepid. We're facing a lot of headwind. We're still trying to repair a lot of damage from a deep, harrowing recession. And we're not going to fix it overnight. I think that's becoming more and more apparent that we continue to take steps forward, but it's not these leaps and bounds, which we'd all love to see, but just don't seem likely, at least not in 2012. I think we're still dealing with the housing market, trying to find its footing and get on some more solid ground there. I think the labor market continues to struggle. Unemployment's high. Payroll job creation hasn't really accelerated yet. So these things are just kind of keeping us in check in terms of growth, as far as growth is concerned.
One of the indicators you mentioned was the labor market. We hear that number is coming down. Should we take anything out of that? Is there some rejoicing to be done because we hear the numbers coming down?
Well, the headline number is what's been coming down, and that gets reported. You're not going to be able to capture the well-being of the economy with a single statistic like that. And all macroeconomic data is flawed in some way or another. Part of the reason that number's been coming down has to do with the way it's calculated. And it does not include someone, if I've been out of work and I'm looking for work, I haven't found anything and I just give up looking. Suddenly, I'm not included in that unemployment figure. In fact, my giving up on the job search makes that number look better. Now, if the unemployment number is coming down because we got people giving up the job search, we're not better off. Right. That's not a healthy labor market. Right. So you got to look at three different angles, I think. You look at payroll, job growth, how many workers are companies hiring, what's happening to that unemployment rate. Of course, we want to see it come down. And the third thing is the labor force. Is the labor force growing, or do we just have more and more people giving up hope? That's what you got to watch. So growing labor force, falling unemployment, growing hiring by businesses. That's the three legs of a healthy labor market stool.
Okay, let's talk about those other two legs, if you will. Let's talk payroll. What are the indicators telling you there?
We've seen sort of sporadic growth as far as payrolls are concerned. You see bursts of hiring, and then the next month things are slow again. There's a lot of uncertainty still in the economy. A lot of it has to do with politics. A lot of it has to do with policy. A lot of it has to do with taxes. What's going to happen? Will the Bush tax cuts expire at the end of 2012? That's one question. What's going to happen with the Dodd-Frank financial regulatory reform, this tremendous piece of legislation that has been foisted on the shoulders of the financial sector, which is already under siege from the crisis, and credit market flows are depressed. So, right. What does that mean? What does healthcare reform mean? Will healthcare reform withstand the Supreme Court challenge? If it does, what parts of it are going to survive? We've already seen some parts drop out. So you've got businesses with all these balls in the air trying to figure out where they're going to land. What do you do? Do you want to run out and hire? Not if you don't have to, you don't. Mm-hmm. And so that's what we see. The workers that are currently employed, we've all become more productive. Fear is a great motivator.
Right.
And so businesses' demand's growing for their goods and services, but they don't have to rush out and hire. They can wait and let's see what happens with all these question marks. What are the answers? And then I'll move forward then.
So this uncertainty has what impact on the business community, the economy, the business world?
If you're a turtle in an uncertain world, you pull your head back into your shell. If you're an armadillo, you curl up in a ball. If you're a businessman or woman, you stand put. You don't take on that new project. You go into wait and see mode. You build up profits because businesses have been making money,
right.
But they're just sitting on that money.
Right.
They're not plunging it back into the hiring. They're not plunging it back into large capital investments. And until that uncertainty resolves itself, then some of that gets released, and I think that's when the hiring picks up as well.
All right, and that labor growth, now we obviously lead right into that, the third leg of the stool. What are we looking for there?
Well, you know, payroll's growing, falling unemployment, labor force growth. A growing labor force means that, you know, there's more people looking for work. So those discouraged workers we talked about a few moments ago, they're back in the hunt. You know, they're now encouraged. They're more optimistic that they can find something. So what happens when the labor market's turning around is as people re-enter that labor force, the labor force is growing. So if it's growing and the unemployment rate's falling and businesses are hiring, then you've got really all the indicators moving in the direction that points towards a labor market recovery.
Right. Okay. So now that's the macro look. I'm thinking national levels. Yep. What about Florida? Let's talk Florida, and then we'll eventually get down to Sarasota sure. and our area. Sure. What are we looking like in the state of Florida?
Well, I mean, I think Florida's recovery continues as well. I think the recovery started in Florida later than the national recovery. I think it was the beginning of 2010 before Florida's economy started to recover. We were in recession before the rest of the nation. So, I mean, we've been in this longer. I think we've gone deeper down into this downturn than the nation as a whole. And housing, of course, was at the epicenter of all this, and we're still struggling. Those things are weighing on Florida's recovery, but we have seen signs, again, those labor market indicators right. also showing up in Florida. Strong growth? No, but growth nonetheless. So we've got a long way to climb out of the hole that we're in, but there's evidence that we're starting to claw our way up at least.
Sarasota obviously would be our focus here. Our region certainly would be inclusive as well. What are your thoughts as we look towards 2012? We felt some things here pretty badly. How bad were they, first of all? Where are we in terms of the recovery, and what can we anticipate as we go through this coming year?
Yeah, good questions. Sarasota, you know, I tend to think of regional economies like, you know, you're a duck in a kiddie pool that's in a swimming pool on the top of a cruise liner that's out on the ocean. I mean, the ocean is the global economy. You can't control the swells, the storms, the currents. That cruise ship is the U.S. economy.
Right.
The captain and policymakers in Washington, D.C., they're going to steer that as best they can given the swells in the ocean. The pool on the top deck, that's Florida. You know, they're making policy in Tallahassee. Things are happening at a state level. Sarasota metro area, it's a baby pool floating in that swimming pool on
exactly.
the top, and then the counties are the little ducks, and you swim around in there. Now you can move this way and that way, but you're not going to get away from the ocean liner. You're not going to get away from the global swells. And so the things we've talked about nationally are for Florida, they apply here as well. The labor market's struggling. The housing market's looking to turn around. One thing here that I think is a little bit different than the state as a whole is population growth.
Right.
I think is showing signs of improving more quickly here in this part of Florida than in Florida as a whole. That goes back to, I think, recovery in the stock market and an increase in the value of financial assets. So a more affluent retiree, that's what drives their retirement decisions. You know, average retirees like yourself and me, we got to sell a house
right.
to finance our retirees. So right. we haven't seen those people come back yet.
Beautiful. Okay. We'll pick up on the other side of the break and continue to talk about Sarasota, what we can expect here, and what maybe we should be thinking about doing as we continue to recover from this great recession. We'll be right back after these messages.